Hello everyone, welcome back to my channel, and in today's video we are going to learn about life cycle of servlet. So what happens in servlet, how it is started, from the start of the servlet to end of the servlet, we are going to learn about everything in this video. This is also going to be a very short and very simple video. If you have not yet subscribed to my channel, do subscribe and hit the bell icon so that you can receive notifications whenever I post a new video. And let us get into the video. So in servlet life cycle, we have total of 5 steps. Okay, the first one is servlet class is loaded, servlet instance is created. Whatever the instance is related to this class, that instance is created. Every class will have an instance, you know that, right? Next, init method is invoked. Init is nothing but initialization, you can say. Service method is invoked, and then destroy method is invoked. Okay, very simple, you can easily remember them. First you have to load the class, and then you have to load the instance which is related to the class, and then you have to initialize the instance, that means starting of the execution, and then service, providing service, and then last, destroy. After work, you have to just kill the, kill in the sense you have to end the servlet, that's all. So about each and every step, we will now look in detail. Yeah, if you can see this, here we started the process and here we stopped the process, start and end. So in the after starting, what happens first? The class is loaded, then the instance related to this class is loaded, and then init method is invoked. Okay, after this, the servlet will get ready. After servlet gets ready, it will call the service method. After calling service method is nothing but whatever the service, whatever the function the servlet is required to do, the servlet is meant to do, it will do that function. Okay, and after that it will be ended in 5. Fifth step is destroy, right? So in this duration, 1, 2, 3 steps are performed. Here fourth step is performed, and here fifth step is performed. Okay, now we will see about each of them. First, servlet class is loaded. This is our first step, right? Loading servlet class. So you will have a class loader which will load the servlet class. With the help of class loader, we will be loading the servlet class. Okay, done. Next, this is loaded. So when do we load the servlet class? When first request is received by the servlet. This is the servlet, right? This is our servlet, and our servlet will be receiving request from the web browser. Client will be sending the request to the server or the servlet through web browser, right? First actually it will send to the server, and then server will send it to servlet, right? So whenever the first request is received by the servlet, whenever the servlet will get its first request, then the servlet class is loaded. Class loader will load the class. Okay, then after loading the class, what happens is creating servlet instance. So instance, whatever the instance is related to this class, that instance is created. Okay, so once, as soon as the loading of the class is completed, then its related instance will be created. Okay, then it is done only once throughout the entire life cycle of the servlet. Instantiation, that means creating a servlet instance, is done only once. Got it? Next. So this is about loading class and creating the instance of that particular class. Done. Now, next we have third step we have is init method. Init method is nothing but simply it is short form of initialization. Instead of writing initialization entire keyword, we will just write it as init. Don't confuse by thinking it as int, int. It is not int, it is init. Okay, init method, it will initialize the class, or it will start the class. It is responsible for starting the servlet or starting the process of the servlet. Okay, and what is the syntax we use? Public void init servlet configuration and configuration, two parameters we'll be using, and you'll not write entire configuration word, you'll just write config. Okay, so this is about init method. As soon as the instance is created, next init method will be invoked. Okay, that means init method will be called. Next we have is service method. Okay, and in service method, what happens is you will have a servlet, right? Servlet will be getting request. right? Client related request will be sent to the servlet. Each time servlet receives a request, it will get multiple requests, right? For each request, it will be calling the service method, okay? Each time when the request is received by the servlet, this service method is called, okay? Suppose if the servlet is not yet initialized, that means if this step is not done, then it will first go to the first step, then it will load the servlet class, it will create the instance, it will start init method, and then service method will invoke, right? If the init method is already invoked, then directly it will get into the service method, okay? First it will check whether the received request is initialized or not. If it is not initialized, it will go back to the first step and the process continues from the first step, okay? Now, and this is also initialized only once. Like how we are creating servlet instance for only one time, this service method is also this service method is also invoked only for one time. And what is the syntax? Public void service servlet request response servlet response response. That means request and responses you will be having, right? Request is client will be requesting this server, and server will be requesting the servlet, and response is nothing but servlet will send the response to the server and server will send the response to the client, okay? That is about service method, providing service. The main motto is to provide the service related. Next, last we have destroy method. In destroy method, what do we do? Before removing the servlet instance, that means once the work related to the server is done, before before deleting the servlet instance, then the destroy method is called, okay? Destroy method is called. It gives, like, if there are any resources or there are any files or any threads or anything going on in the servlet, it will give the chance to the servlet to release all of them, to remove all of them, to clean up. And then it will call destroy method in at which the servlet will be ended, right? So this is done before removing the servlet instance. Once we call the destroy method, the servlet is dead there, right? So we have 5 steps total. Class is loaded, instance is created, and init method is called, and service method is called, and then destroy method is called, right? This is about life cycle of servlet. Very simple and very short and very, very, very important as well. And also, this is very simple. Don't get confused, right? And if you have understood clearly whatever I've explained in the video, don't forget to hit the like button and don't forget to share it with your friends. If you want me to include any other topics or any other subjects, let me know in the comment section so that I'll do it for you if I can. And if you have missed out the previous videos in this playlist, I will give you the link in the description. You can check out the link and you can have a look at the other videos as well. And don't forget to comment what you feel about the video in the comment section, whether you're understanding it, whether you're not, am I going slow or am I going fast, anything, feel free to comment it in the comment section so that I will know what you guys are feeling about the video. And thank you for watching the video.